Hello all, welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video, I'll be talking about how to create chart of account structure and the chart of account structure instance. So let me get into Fusion environment. Okay, so before I get there, there are some dependencies. So in today's video, we'll be talking about these four steps. So chart of account structure and chart of account structure instance. But in order to do that, first we need to create the value set and also create the chart of account structure, and then under the structure, create the segments, assign the segment labels and flexible qualifiers, and then create the chart of account structure. So first we'll start with the value set. From my training videos perspective, I'm actually planning to create my enterprise structure in this way. So Reliance Enterprise is my enterprise structure, and within that, I'll be having the Reliance INR ledger, Reliance USD ledger, and under Reliance INR ledger, I'll be having Reliance Communications and Reliance Textiles INC as the legal entities, where for the Reliance Communications, the company code would be 01, which is your balance segment value. Reliance Textiles, the company code would be 02. And again, under this, if you take another Reliance Communication example, Reliance Postpaid, Reliance Prepaid would be the business units. Similarly, under Reliance Textiles, Reliance Cotton Extraction, Reliance Cloth Manufacturing would be BU, and so on. Similarly, under Reliance USD ledger, you have two legal entities and one BU under that. And similarly, for Reliance Canadian ledger, I'll have one company, Reliance Software. And for that, there will be company code 05. And there will be, again, business units under Reliance Software as well. Okay. So from this structured perspective, I'm planning to create a chart of accounts with the four segment structure, and the four segments would be, let me go here. I'll be creating four segments: company, cost center, account, and intercompany. So from a Oracle perspective, whenever you are creating a chart of accounts, company and account, national account are two mandatory and all others are optional. So I'll go with four segment structure: company, cost center, account, and intercompany. For company and cost center, I will create these value sets. As far as account is concerned, I will use the Oracle seeded corporate account value set. And for intercompany, again, I'll use the same value set as that of the your company. So I need to create now two value sets. For intercompany, I'll be using the same thing. And for account, I'll be using the Oracle provided seeded value set. Okay. So this is the task: manage chart of accounts value set. That's the task under which we can create the value sets. Okay. Go to the setup and maintenance, and under setup and maintenance, go for global search. Okay, under manage value sets, so click on plus and start creating your value set. So first I will be creating a Reliance company, right? So I'll just say Reliance company. So if it's a value set code, there should not be any spaces. I'm using underscore Reliance company, and module would be general ledger. And validation type, independent value set. And value, I'll go with the character. I mean, you can go for a number, but I want to go with character because in future, if you want, even if you use character, then it can be alphanumeric. It's not just numbers. And then value subtype, I'll go with the text. Minimum length, I'll go with 3. Yeah, so save and close. So that's the one value set. I'll create one more value set, which is Reliance cost center. And the module would be general ledger, validation type independent. So if I go with the validation type of independent, I can create a value set values under this value set. Value data type, again I'll go with the character so that it can be alphanumeric, and value subtype would be text. minimum length for cost center, I'll go with say 4 segment. Again, save and close. And as far as the account is concerned, as I said, I'll be using the Oracle provided CTET corporate account. Let me check if the corporate account value set exists. It should. I can show you that. Yeah. So this is the value set corporate. Okay. So we are done with creating of the value set. Next thing would be creating of the chart of account structure. So when you create your chart of account structure, somewhere you'll be using the value sets, and hence we have created the value set, as that's a prerequisite. So if you go for manage chart of account structure, that's the task. So let's say cancel. Yeah, so manage chart of account structure is the task. Yeah, manage chart of account structures. So here you can see under manage chart of account, search for general ledger. Search for general ledger and then click on manage structures and then click on plus. So I'll be creating, maybe I'll just call it as Reliance COA, Reliance chart of account, and a delimiter. I want to use a delimiter of say dot and hit save. So once hit save, you can, this is the structure, and under the structure you can create the segments. So the first segment would be a Reliance company, that's the segment. Yeah, that's a value set. Okay, so I should call it as company. APNA is company, company, company. I can use the same thing. And sequence number one, prompt also I'll use the same thing, company. And this is the flexible qualifier, which is a primary balancing segment. And the short prompt is, I'll just say company, display length 3 digits, column name, first segment. And this is where you need to assign the value set code. So what is the value set code? Reliance underscore company. Search for that. Reliance company. Okay. Just say save and close. So that's the first one. Now click create the second one. The second one is cost center. As far as the API name is concerned, there should not be any spaces. Sequence number two, prompt would be cost center. And I'll use the cost center flex field qualifier. And then this is the cost center, display length 4. I just want this to be a segment 2. And value set code. Yeah, Reliance cost center. Save and close. So that's the second segment. Now, third segment. Third segment is account, and we'll use the seeded value set. Third segment, account, and this is a national account segment. Short prompt, ACC. I mean, you can use the same thing as well. Display segment, probably I'll use maybe this is accounted, so 4 segments. And this is a third segment. And the value set code is corporate account. Let's search for that. That's the third segment. Now the last segment, which is a intercompany segment. Again, this would be sequence number four, intercompany, and the flex field qualifier should be intercompany segment. Short form, short prompt is IC, display length 3. This would be fourth segment. And as far as the value set is concerned, as I said, we should be using the same value set as that of the company. So it's Reliance company. Save and close. Okay, now we have four segments under chart of account structure. You can just do save and close. So we have done the value set, we have done creation of the chart of account structure. Under start chart of account structure, we have created the segments and assigned the segment labels or flexible qualifiers. Now we'll be creating a chart of account structure instance. So, I mean, chart of account structure is basically this a PeopleSoft concept. It is like a copy of the chart of account structure. So in this case, chart of account structure, whatever you have created is a kind of a template. And this chart of account structure is the chart of account structure instance is what you want to use. So this is kind of a template. And within this, using this particular template, you are creating your own chart of account structure. So, and this is called a chart of account structure instance. So I'll use this navigation, manage chart of account structure instances. So click on done. Yeah, so yeah, you can search for this chart of account structure instance, which is this one. And then click on plus for the chart of account structure instances. Search for global general ledger. Yeah, this is the one, chart of account structure instances. What is our structure name? Reliance chart of accounts. So search for Reliance chart of accounts, and under this, create a chart of account structure instance. So this is a code. So I'll just say Reliance COA instance. Reliance COA instance, Reliance chart of accounts instance. It's enabled dynamic combination allowed. Structure name, what is my structure name? Reliance COA. And as soon as you do that, you should be able to see the four segments under this. Okay, now select each of this and make it as required. Obviously, whenever you're creating any transaction, we want all these segments to be entered. Okay, so we have created the chart of account instance. So save and close. Search for this. It's enabled. Just say done. Search. And then the last step would be to deploy FlexField. So when you click on deploy FlexField, okay, it is going to check if there are any kind of errors or warnings. So this basically deployment is actually trying to validate all the chart of account structure instances within this particular environment. So this being a testing environment, there are different people who are creating different chart of account structure instances. So let's see if we find any errors or whether the chart of account structure deployment would be successful. Without deployment, you should not be using this chart of account structure instances. So while it's getting deployed, so let me try to add deploy chart of account structure. This is my eighth step. Generally, it takes a while. So what I'll do is I'll pause my video and then I'll restart the video once the deployment is completed. So let me pause recording. I don't know, it's taking extremely long time. It stopped at 100%, but otherwise, this is the last step. Once the deployment is completed, you should be able to see the deployment status with a green tick mark here. So probably in my next video, then I'll show the next steps, that is how to create segment values and how to assign value attributes to the segment values and creating of the accounting calendar. And this would be followed by creating of the ledger, because in order to create the ledger, you need to have the chart of account structure instance and of course the calendar. So that's the reason why we are going in this sequence. So once this is done, we'll go with the creation of the primary ledger. Thank you. Thanks for watching my video. For interesting videos on financials, please do subscribe to my channel. Thank you.